CRISPR is most well known for making gene editing so easy, scientists had to pump the brakes for a second and talk about the ethical implications of playing God. But while we haven't figured out yet exactly where to draw the line on messing with the human genome, I think we can all agree we're cool with using this revolutionary technique to mess with harmful bacteria, because we hate those guys. Researchers are developing a CRISPR pill, which could help fight bacteria that have developed a resistance to other forms of antibiotics, the much-feared superbugs. Best of all, killing bacteria using CRISPR turns their own defense against them. CRISPR is not just how I like my bacon, it's also an acronym that stands for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindromic Repeat. It refers to sequences in bacteria's DNA that are pretty much what they sound like, short sequences that are partially the same backwards and forwards that are spaced out regularly. CRISPR is actually a bacterium's defense mechanism against viruses. That's right, bacteria get viruses. It's a virus-eat-bacteria world out there. Anyway, when a virus attacks a bacterium, it injects its DNA into it. But if the bacterium has been attacked by this kind of virus before, it's saved a bit of its DNA in between the CRISPR strains. The bacteria will use that as a template to create a strand of RNA that can target the virus's DNA. Once the RNA is locked on, a protein called CRISPR-associated protein 9, or Cas9 to its friends, chops up the virus DNA and renders it harmless. It's like an ingenious primitive immune system. So scientists thought, what if we use this bacterial defense to make the bacteria destroy its own DNA? Researchers are figuring out how to do exactly that. And to add insult to injury, they want to use a virus to infect the bacteria and convince them to destroy their own DNA. It takes a little more finesse than just swallowing a pill of viruses, because the stomach acid would break them down. So the plan is to shroud the virus in innocuous bacteria, like a Trojan horse. Once the good bacteria make it through the stomach, the virus reveals itself before forcing the bacteria to commit suicide. Disguised viruses using bacteria's own weapons against them for revenge? It's like Game of Thrones up in there. It's awesome. The best thing about this approach is it can be used to target very specific bacteria, which is what you want in an antibiotic. Broad-spectrum antibiotics kill swaths of bacteria indiscriminately, whether they're good or bad. Their overuse has created bacteria that are becoming more and more resistant to antibiotics, and if antibiotics become ineffective, that's a huge step backwards for humanity. Remember the bubonic plague? Yeah, neither do I, and I don't want to. This research has a ways to go before it's ready to start busting gut microbes. The delivery method is in its early stages and hasn't been tested on animals. Plus, right now, the researchers are just targeting one species of bacteria, C. difficile. While C. difficile is a drug-resistant bacterium classified as an urgent threat by the CDC, it's just one species, so the same virus can't be used to fight other bacteria because viruses tend to be one-species-only kind of murderers. Still, we're in dire need of new ways to fight antibiotic-resistant bacteria, and if we can kill them in the most ironic way possible, I say heck yeah, more research is needed. Special thanks to our sponsor, domain.com. When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. And you can get 15% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use coupon code SEEKER at checkout. CRISPR's most well-known use is genetic engineering, and Trace goes in depth on how it does that right up here. So are you worried about superbugs, or do you think we'll science our way out of this one? Let us know in the comments, don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching Seeker.